say, my name's Chad Webb, 38 years old, and I am an addict. I began experimenting with drugs at age 14. It all started with alcohol, and over the years progressed to harder and harder drugs until, at age 30, I found myself helpless and hooked on prescription painkillers. After 16 years of breaking self-indulgence and selfish behavior, I had burned all my options. My family and friends had enough, and I was guided with other addicts in my career. The scary part is I couldn't care less. All I was worried about was how I was going to get my next high. For some reason, God saw fit to save me, and He did it through Operation United. In 2005, I sold power marijuana to an undercover United officer. This transaction kicked into motion a sequence of events that further changed and saved my life. I was indicted and sentenced to a 3-year prison sentence, and that was a gift from God. I made bonds on the charges, had a couple of months before my final sentencing, and that's why I continue on my addiction. And I used all the way up to the day I went to jail, and even managed to smuggle some drugs in with me. They just lasted a few days, but I detoxed for what seemed forever. I think it was a month or so before the hate began to live. My mind began to work, and all my past flooded back to me. In jail, you have a lot of time. A lot of time, nothing but time. I wallowed in self-pity for months. Morally, it was a daily topic of conversation. 7 months into my sentence, I got indicted on some more traffic charges. With my new charge, I made short probation with the stipulation that I completed treatment. Once again, God stepped in, and through tonight, paid my way from West Carroll to Colorado Treatment Facility at Camp Kentucky. I couldn't care less about treatment. I just knew it was better than jail, so I jumped at the chance to get out. Up to this point, I still had no intention to get sober. I was still self-serving, doing whatever made me feel better. I went through the paces for the first couple of weeks of treatment, just trying to plug through. But the longer I was there, the more everything started to make sense. I realized what a chance I'd be given, and I took full advantage of it that day forward. I graduated the program on July 6, 2006. My life is now far beyond what I ever thought it could be. I married the woman of my dreams, and I have 5 awesome children. Life's not all rainbow unicorns, that's for sure, but life is great. I've been completely abstinent from drugs and alcohol since March 6, 2006. That's 2,741 days today. That's 2,741 days that I've been a good dad and husband. 2,741 days that I've had with my family and friends. And 2,741 days I probably wouldn't have had without help from you people. Help from 2 deciding factors in my sobriety. Jesus Christ and Operation United. Without any more, I wouldn't stand here before you today, this day, which is September 6, 2013. Exactly 8 years to the day that I was finally sentenced and in prison. See, ladies and gentlemen, nothing, absolutely nothing, happened in God's world by mistake. Step 12 says, having had a spiritual awakening as we grow all these steps, we carry this message to other addicts and practice these principles in all our affairs. The reason I was saved is simple. God does not bless me if you do it. God doesn't work for me, but a man can do God's work. I have stayed active in the recovery community over the years. And once again, through tonight, have had the opportunity to spread my blessings on to others. On 7 different occasions, United has helped me and funded treatment for people I knew. People that were hopeless, people that were low down where I'd been. And they approached me and asked me how I did it. Not once did they turn me down. And for that, I want to applaud United for all of their diligent work and tireless effort in the war on drugs. The war on drugs is far from over, but as for me, this battle has been won. Thank you.